Okay, so we all know that we cover extraordinary stories every day right here in KTLA, but some incredible events have somehow been forgotten.
Yeah, they're top of the headline for a few days and then they go away. Emmy-winning news writer and producer Bob Dlugos discussing some of them in his brand new book. It's called Forgotten Tragedies. Thanks for being here, Bob.
Oh, it's my pleasure.
Appreciate
it. It's available on Amazon. I want to get that out of the way right away.
Very smart.
Well, you know, I did an interview in Las Vegas yesterday, and I forgot to tell people, go to Amazon to buy the book. I was so wrapped up in the interview.
Well done. One of the stories that really hits home for us is the story of Kathy Fiscus. It's featured in your book.
Poor little Kathy. She was, you know, it was a national story, actually, and people in Los Angeles, a lot of people remember it. But outside of L.A., people are not familiar with it. It was back in 1949, and little Kathy fell down a well. This was 35 years before baby Jessica fell down the well in Texas, which people still remember that story. It took about 18 hours for rescuers to get to her, and during that time, legendary KTLA anchor Stan Chambers basically cut his teeth on that story, doing it live, staying on the air the whole time, and people were transfixed to their radios all over the country, wanting to know what was going to happen. And sadly, Kathy did not make it. But it really did put KTLA on the map, and of course you guys now are as big as it comes live when it comes to live news.
Yeah, it was also television history, which makes it even that more impactful.
Exactly, for the few televisions that were available in the day, people were watching.
Absolutely. You know, these days, obviously, these deadly school shootings seem like it's happening here, but there is history of that as well.
Absolutely,
all the way back from the 20s.
Absolutely, back in 1927 in Michigan. You know, it's kind of ironic. Here we are celebrating the Sandy Hook tragedy, the anniversary of that tragedy. But people have totally forgotten about this terrorist bombing of a schoolhouse back in 1927. Basically, what happened was a member of the school board didn't get reelected. He had a violent temper, and his wife was going through some serious health problems. And he just snapped and decided he was going to take it out on the school and on the kids. And so he started planting dynamite underneath the school and connected it to a little alarm clock. And on the morning of the tragedy at 8:45, the alarm went off. The blast obliterated a quarter of the school. And they said it threw children into the air, and it was just a terrible scene.
These things, quite a few. When the miners are trapped in the mine, and we follow for weeks. See, these things kind of unite us all for a brief period of time.
Absolutely.
Like the fires have kind of united us all in care and concern and worry. There's one more vignette, the molasses disaster.
Oh, this is my favorite story from the book.
Not my favorite story, but my Burroughs.
But my Burroughs. Yes. It was a flood that happened. It was a large vat of molasses that was situated over the main street of a town. Well, they didn't build the vat correctly, and the seams gave way, and the molasses flooded out of the container and down the street, and about 10 people drowned in that. And we should probably get the snake story in, too, just since we teased that.
We got to run on that here. But
he's a TV guy.
Good.
He knows about TV.
Yes. We got the 20. We should tell you, it's digestible nuggets of history.
Absolutely.
Each of them was fascinating enough to capture everyone's attention for a few days or a few weeks. It's called Forgotten Tragedies. It's on Amazon. You know, we need to know our history. These happen to be some of the most bizarre or headline-grabbing.
I think so, too. Very compelling story.
It's my version of history. It's like two pages. I can handle it.
Exactly.
Thank you so much for being
here.
Thank
you.
I really appreciate it.
Thanks for being here, Bob.
Thank you.
Bob and I used to work together in Bakersfield. He was my boss.
Oh.